Hey y'all, welcome back to What I'm On Today. Today, let's look at my fall haul. Stay tuned.
Thankful for this beat. Thankful for my dad, man, he kept me from the street. Man, I'm thankful when I eat. Thankful for my wife, thankful for my freak. When they saw each other last week.
Hey y'all, welcome back to What I'm On Today. My name is Lakia Chanel and I make videos of those little things, handbags, both luxury and contemporary, because you guys already know that I do not discriminate. So today I wanted to show you guys some of the things that I have picked up over the past month or so that you haven't seen. And these are things from clothing, shoes, and of course, handbags. So as a preface, some of these things, most of these things were bought either in preparation for or while I was on my trip to Europe recently. Now I'm going to do another video that is going to be all about that trip to Europe, but this is just a couple of things that I picked up. Not all the things, because some of the things I'm still waiting on. So I want to get started with clothing. I have not purchased that many pieces at all this year. Like, for whatever reason, this year has been like 1,000,000,000% all about handbags, which a lot of the years are. But usually I'm buying clothes and things like that. Not so much this year. I went to Europe with no coat in the fall for a reason. I knew that I wanted to get a coat when I got there. That's kind of been like a little tradition over the past couple of times that I've gone. And I really wanted a black or a navy blue full-length trench coat to put in my closet, because I'm kind of missing this all-weather type of coat. And let me tell you guys, it was really chilly when we went, and this was so perfect. This actually elevated so many of my outfits. I got this from Mango. I was very specific. I needed something that had lining in it. And I ended up paying 149 euro for this. I think this retailed for 225 in the United States. So I will put the link below, because guys, to me, this is worth it. I wore this every single day for 2 weeks. So this does need to go into the cleaners at this point, but it is great. It's double breasted. It has little flaps here, which is great. I love this. There is a little nozzle right here that closes up so you can get some close cut to the neck. It has a belt to it, and then it has a split in the back, and it is literally full length. I'm about 5'5"-ish, and this was like literally to my ankle. So I love this. This came in the traditional beige trench coat. It came in black, and it also came in blue. I got a size large, and I'll have some mod shots of me actually wearing this. I got a size large because I wanted to be able to put clothing, sweaters. I wanted to close it up. Next, we're gonna go into the shoes. So these were a pair of shoes that I got pre-vacation for vacation. These are the Sambas. They're in black. They have these cute little embroidered flowers on them, which are so, so, so cute. I needed a pair of black sneakers, but I wanted something that was, y'all know me, a little bit extra. I love all the adornments. So these were really cute. And I love these because these were literally $100. So yes to the Samba, and they were super comfortable. I broke them in on the trip. They got drenched wet. They probably need to be cleaned at this point, but they were really amazing for all the things that I need them to be. So these were a great, great buy for $100. I will be wearing them all year round. The next pair of shoes I got were yet another pair of Sambas. These ones I got from JD Sports. I will link all of the stuff that I have here below if it's available. These are kind of like a purple silvery color. I just thought these were super cute. I had a gift card, so I paid like $45 for these, but I think these were $99 or $100 as well. Very, very comfortable. I did want an all leather pair, so this was kind of like my all leather pair. And this went perfectly. These were the only two pair of shoes that I brought to my trip to Europe, were these ones and then the Sambas that you guys just saw. And they literally went with every outfit. And then with my trench coat, elevated every single outfit. Sticking with traditions. Every single time we go to Paris, we typically go to this store called Kith, which sells like a bunch of different brands as well as their own brand. And I always kind of leave with a pair of shoes over the past couple, maybe three times that I've gone, 3 years, three times that I've gone there. And so this was no different. These are another pair of, I think they're considered Sambas, but it is a collaboration with Naked. And I don't know the company Naked. I just saw these and thought they were so cute. And they are basically made of suede at the toe box and at the back. And then the rest of it is lace and then the canvas. And I thought these would be so great. They were so unique. And so I know that I'm going to be wearing these for sure in the summertime. And usually what I like to do is get a couple of pins. So I got a couple of pins this time so that I could pop onto my shoes. And these were 99 euro. So a little over $100. I did not see these available in the United States, but I think you can get them like resale from the last time that I checked. But I'll have a link below to any ones that I find. The last pair of shoes that are new to my little shoe collection are these shoes. So my mother-in-law and I love shoes and bags. And so she picked me up these for my birthday, which is great because I was definitely looking for a pair of black and white loafers. And now I don't have to buy any. These are super cute. They are from JCPenney, and it's their Worthington brand. I got these in a size, I think she got, 9.5, which fit perfectly. And they are just absolutely adorbs. So the tag said they were $65. I'm pretty sure she got them on sale. I don't know how much they are because I haven't checked yet, but I'll have the link below. But I will say that I do like the Worthington brand. I have a couple of pair of sandals from JCPenney's and their Worthington brand, and they are like chef's kiss. They are great, and they've lasted for years and years and years. So yes, if you're looking for something that is not super expensive, but definitely cute, check these out. A bag that you guys know. So I know that you guys saw my video on whether I was going to keep this or not. I decided to indeed keep it, and I've worn it a couple of times, and I'm kind of glad that it's here. Like, it has its own space in the collection. It's kind of cuter than just a regular tote bag. It's a little bit oomphed than that, and a little bit more comfortable to carry than my Rogue 30 in the size 40. My Rogue 39. So I actually do like this, and it's pretty lightweight as well. So I did, as I mentioned, obviously it's here. I decided to keep it. So you guys have already seen this, but this was another bag that kind of was in that fall-ish time frame. One of the bags that I purchased during my Europe trip was this Lancel bag. I think this is the size medium, and it has this cute little face on it and the adornments on the hang tag. So I went to Paris in April of this year. We took our mothers, and I got my first Lancel bag, which is down there. And when I was there, I saw this bag and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so cute. But I decided not to get it. And it's kind of been on my brain. I was looking on Farfetch for it. And so when I came back, I went to the Lancel store. They didn't have this out. And I said, I know you guys don't have this because it's old, but do you happen to have this? And he did. So I snatched this up. I had brought my my Bottega cassette bag, which is like, I always bring that probably 90% of the time for my travel bag. But once I got this, this was so lightweight. I got this on my third day there. And so I wore it for the rest of the 12 days. This one pretty much every single day. And it was great. It was so awesome. I will tell you that I did have to return it. So I started off in Paris, went to Florence, and then came back to Paris. And when I came back to Paris, or maybe my last day in Florence, the strap on this broke. This has little screws, and I think one of the screws ended up coming out. So went back to the Lancel store. Obviously, they swapped it out for a brand new one, no problem. So Lancel is not in the United States, although you can purchase online and they will ship to the United States. But there is a 2-year warranty, which I just found out, on all of their bags. So if you ever have any problems with it, you can always send it back, get your money back, or get repairs or whatever you need. But this was like such a gem, and it fits so much in the bag. It has a little slip pocket for cards, and it's a zip pocket, and then the inside is this cute little bright pink in textile. I had the best time wearing this bag, so I'm so happy to have this one, and it fits so much stuff, and it was just so comfortable, to wear. So just a little cheeky fun here. And this one was 495 euro, so very affordable as well. And the last thing from my fall haul is my Hanifa bag. So if you guys recall, on my community page, I purchased this bag back in August. It came to me like mid-October. So it was boxed really greatly. You guys look up here to see the unboxing. I wanted the bag because the shape was just so great. And I was like, this is something I don't have in my collection. So the leather on the outside, I really love it. It's minimal branding. It says Hanifa kind of engraved in the leather on the bottom. I don't mind branding. Give me all the branding. But this is minimal branding. And it's still very, very nice. The inside of the bag is a textile, kind of like a micro suede. It has a zip pocket on one side, as you guys can see. And then on the other side, it has a pretty large slip pocket. And then it also comes with this huge pouch, as well as a crossbody strap. The size of the bag is a pretty decent size. I think because of the way it's shaped, it depends what you have in here. I think it does fit a decent amount. I use this for work one day, and my laptop is huge. It has to be like a 15 or so. And so the laptop did not go across, but it did stand up and down, and I had some hand room. It was definitely, you know, above this cute little V, and I had some hand room that I popped in here. Like, and the price point for the bag, I'm not mad. It's perfect. I feel like it's perfectly priced for what it is. I think this bag was $500 or $550 or something like that. And for the uniqueness of the shape and the leather on the outside of the bag, it's great. And it comes with an extra pouch, like, it's great. So with this bag, you can push in the sides. Let's see if I can do it right now. To make it another shape if you so chose to. I think that this is really, actually, this is a super cute little small tote. I think I love it with the sides pushed out. Like, the original style is what drew me to this. So I think that I will probably always wear mine like this because it's adorable. All right, guys, those are the things in my fall haul. I am going to be coming out, I say this all the time, with a vlog. I have been trying to vlog y'all, and y'all, it is a lot. Like, putting all the clips together is a lot. So I am working on my vlog from Paris and Italy so that you guys can see all the fun stuff that we were able to do and all the sites that we were able to see. And then I have a couple more pieces that I am waiting on that I got made while I was out there. So maybe that's going to happen in December or at the beginning of the year. But this is what I have so far. I think these are going to be my last-ish purchases for the year. I say ish because, you know, I keep my options open. But yes, I think this is going to finalize it for the year. So you guys will see the vlog coming up. And then at some point, maybe you guys are going to see like a collection video or what's new or something like that. But either way, thank you guys for spending more time with me here at One On One today. And I will see you guys soon. Bye. Thank you.